Hey guys, it's Tiara Yasmin. Welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a Valentine's Day inspired set. And keep a close eye on the design itself because you might just be like, oh, it's pink, that's why it's Valentine's Day, but it's actually a little bit deeper than that. So I'll get to that a little bit later. But here are all the tools that I used. And this little brush actually has a little heart design on it, which I think is so cute. So I've had a few requests for some longer videos, and while I typically don't include both hands when I'm doing a set because they're usually the exact same, I'm gonna do that here because these are gonna actually be two different designs on the nails on either hand. So that's why I'm gonna make this a little bit longer. I think this is gonna turn out to be at least a 10-minute video. So for all the girls that like longer videos, this one's for you. I'm just going ahead and putting a base coat on all of my nails. This way I have a good foundation to work with. I also like to buff out all my nails. I know some people don't, they just go right in with the base coat, but for me, I've got to put a little bit of buffing on there just so I feel like the base coat is secure. Next step, if you guys know me, then you know that I stick to the pretty much exact same base colors for my French tips. I just love these colors that I get from Amazon. I'll have them linked down below in my storefront so you guys can access them as well. I like these a lot because they're definitely a pretty universal flesh tone, and they're just super easy to work with, and they have very good opacity. So I'm going in with that nude color just once and then two times with the pinky color. I'm going through this kind of fast because nothing special here or anything difficult. I'm just applying these and layering them because I want these French tips to have more of a pink hue to them. So one hand is going to have white French tips with a cheetah print design, and the other is going to have pink French tips with a cheetah print design, just different colors. So I'm just going to go in and take my time and really work out this French tip. It does take me a long time sometimes to get that perfect arch because I like my French tips to have that really deep arch to them. I know some people like when it cuts off kind of like halfway onto the side, but for me, this is my style that I really like to go to. So if you guys are interested in this style as well, I do sell these press-ons via my website. As of right now, I'm just using Etsy, but I am in the works of creating a website, so I'll link all that down below so you guys can check me out and, of course, purchase some nails like this. My method for my French tips is kind of just taking a bit of nail polish on my liner brush and then making hash marks going up, more or less just to get the excess off, but then also kind of trying to find that middle of my peak, kind of like that apex of my French tip. So I like doing that. It works for me. I know there's so many different ways to do French tips, and there's a lot of different types of French tips. There's no right way, in my opinion, to do it. It's whatever you like and whatever you're trying to achieve. So for this look, definitely going for a deep arch of a French tip, and typically when I get to my pinky nail, I make the French tip a little bit shorter, if that makes sense, just because I feel like it makes more sense for a small finger. So that's kind of how I go about that. In the meantime, I'm going to go and do the same thing with this hand, but in pink. I think because I do French tips so often, I've gotten pretty good at making them pretty much all the same height, which I think is really nice. So something that I've learned is just to take your time with this, and if it really helps you, you can go ahead and compare the nails that are directly next to each other or the ones from a different hand to make sure that you're kind of on the right track. All the French tips are complete. I'm gonna take my daughter's tool. I got this one off Amazon. I just love it a lot because it's super convenient. I'm going to go in and make a bunch of little dots on the nails. These are going to serve as my kind of middle parts of my cheetah print. I should have made more now looking back at this. I feel like whenever I finished and I looked at the final product, I wish they just had a little bit more of the design on each nail. But if you guys look closely, I am making little heart-shaped dots, or just heart shapes. So like I said before, this is a Valentine's Day set. So this is my little subtle way of making it Valentine's-y. Now with a pink that's a little bit darker, I'm gonna go in and complete the cheetah print. I'm using a kind of smaller ball tool on that little pinwheel of a device that I'm using. And I'm just going in and making that cheetah print really evident and kind of making it pop, and I love the contrast of all these colors, and it just works together really nice. Then of course, I'm going to do the exact same thing on the other hand. These dots on the inside are going to be white, and then the outsides are going to be like a hot pink. So again, making random little ones of hearts just so I can have that little subtle hint of a Valentine's Day set. For this nail, I thought it was cute. However, I like the white nail just a little bit better. I feel like the contrast of these two pinks just isn't my favorite, which is odd because this kind of reminds me of the color scheme that I have for my new branding. So I don't know, it just, for some reason, this nail looks a little bit funny. But tell me, what do you guys think about this contrast of colors? Do you like it, or do you think the pinks should have been a little bit different? Let me know, because I think it's, you know, relatively cute, but I just feel like for some reason it's missing a little something. So I went a little step further and noticed that the set was cute after I like looked at it, but I felt like it was missing a little bit of something. So I went out on a whim and kind of just did an outline of the French tip. I will say this is not my strong suit, like, at all. Like, I feel like I tried my absolute best to make this as thin as possible and not like go over it too many times, otherwise it starts to look a little weird. But I wanted it to be straight and really give the French tip a bit of a pop. Yeah, I don't have too much to say about this one. I'm just not that good at it. I think it always turns out better when it's like glitter polished, because there's less of a, you know, structure to the polish, if that makes sense. So if you know, you know, but if you don't, I'm not explaining this very well, so I apologize. But I tried my best to outline these nails and make it look as crisp as possible, but I just wanted to add something a little extra because I felt like the design alone was just not giving enough. Of course, the same on the other hand. Maybe this part made it look a little bit better for me. I feel like whenever the line was not on there, it just wasn't doing enough, but I think it's a little bit cuter with the lines on there. You guys let me know down below, do you guys like the line, or should I not have done this? Because I know not everybody probably thought that I was going to do that, or even thought it was necessary, but give me your opinion. Do you think the line was necessary or not? Lastly, as a final step, I'm just going to go in and add a very small rhinestone to the base of every nail. This is going to give it a little small bit of pop, make it a little bit girlier, and I mean, as if it couldn't be girly enough already, but I'm going to add a little bit of bling just because I feel like it just kind of brought it all together. And that is it, you guys. This is what the final set looks like. I think the two-toned nails was actually a really cool thing. It's actually something I've done before. If you guys have seen my other video of the two-toned Aura nails, I think that turned out so cool. And it's just a little bit funky and something different for the girls. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It does help me out a lot. It helps me get this video in front of more viewers like you guys. If you want to help me spread my craft to more people, be sure to do those things. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!